Hello, Rusty. It's time to get up.
Dad? I think I peed my bed.
Let's go, boy. That pterodactyl looks mighty hungry, and I do believe we're on the menu.
Should I hide in a barrel or something?
Hang on, son. These savages mean business. Now grab my hand and hold on tight.
Oh. Of course.
Am I a ghost?
Yeah, that's it.
I have come here to show you the folly of your ways. Take my hand and you'll travel to...
Come on, Dad. One, we just proved nobody's taking anybody's hand here. And two, you never believed in ghosts. You were a scientist.
Yeah, that's true, I guess.
I whacked my head trying to fix your stupid space station. It's clear you're a traumatic hallucination made manifest by my hitting my... ego.
All right, fine. But I'm still your father. What did you do to my space station?
Oh my God, why can't you take the responsibility of your failure?
Because Gargantua 1 is perfect. The problem has to be your fault.
My fault? Gargantua 1. It's like the worst name for a space station.
I thought it cool.
No, I thought you thought it was cool.
Oh, okay, crazy. Then by your logic, you think you broke my space station.
I've tried everything.
Are you kidding me? You were just flipping switches. Think. Think, Tiny Wonder. You built this with me. You should know her inside and out.
I was like 10. I just wanted to play with my plastic cowboys and Indians. Who lets a 10-year-old build a space station? Oh, great, Dad. Now it's blinking again. Oh, this thing didn't follow Skylab, Dad. I'll never know. Looks like something pierced the hull. Super good. Hey, my diet pills. Where are my diet pills?
Oh, Rusty, you don't need diet pills. You just need to work a few things out.
Luke was telling me this, my dead 12-foot-tall father.
I thought I built a bigger space station than this.
I guess I remember you always towering over me. There you are, you little bugger.
Lad, remember, the solution was in you all the time. All you have to do is...
Hi, Dad.
Your father and I were great friends, you know. In fact, he designed a number of the rides and attractions at the first Brisby theme park. You're probably too young to remember.
Do I have to, Dad?
You said you wanted to help Daddy, son.
I vaguely remember him mentioning it.
And I vaguely remember him mentioning he was dabbling in clone research.
I'm sorry about the TVC-15.
Tom, I'm not worried about that tin can. I'm worried about you. You're not dying on me, and that's an order.
What's going on, Pop?
Everything's fine, son. You're having a nightmare. Kato, take Rusty downstairs and give him some warm milk.
I've got a message for the Action Man.
He's listening, Tom. Go ahead.
I'm happy. Hope you're happy, too.
I've loved all I needed to love.
Don't talk like that, Tom. You're gonna make it. Fight it!
I'm feeling very stiff. And I think my spaceship knows which way to go. Tell my wife I love her very much.
She knows! Ground control to Major Tom. Your circuit's dead. There's something wrong. Can you hear me, Major Tom? Can you hear me? Major Tom!
Ashes. To ashes.
One more, Pop.
Need one with me next to the Metasonic locator?
No, I need one where your suit isn't writing up.
Well, what do you want? It's terry cloth. It acts like a towel. No, I haven't cut it yet. I'm growing it out. The kids wear it long these days. Where have you been?
Okay. Let's just not fight about it, Rusty.
We wouldn't be fighting if you quit writing me about my do. And it's TS now. Nobody calls me Rusty anymore. You're gonna give me a hard time about that now, too?
Not so long as I can still call you... son.
Whatever turns you on, man.
Helper says hello. Shall I put him on?
No, look, Dad, I gotta go. How does my father always know when I'm in my room?
Hello, Rusty.
Daddy? What are you doing in Mommy's womb?
I came to tell you, son. There is another venture.
Why are you talking like Yoda?
This is your dream, Rusty. You tell me.
Just pack up your little shanty town and leave.
You really don't remember me. All those adventures we had?
Wow, that little brown boy saved your life.
Well, this Aztec calendar says today is your lucky day.
Can we keep him, Pop?
Yeah, no, not ringing a bell.
Hello, Rusty.
It's Grandpa.
It's
he's alive.
Your
and trapped in the Phantom Zone.
I knew
he's
you'd
just
find
kidding.
This tape.
Jeez,
you're
I'm
always
not a tard.
Such a little video buff.
Once, I told him once, I wanted to make videos. Next thing you know, every holiday, it's cameras, how-to books.
So yeah, Pop, I've been meaning to tell you, I'm not really that into neckerchiefs.
You wear them well.
Wait, what did he say? Go back.
What I have to tell you is a matter of the gravest importance, Rusty. It has to do with those mysterious deep space radio signals. You know, the ones I received back when you were just a boy.
But what does it mean?
You can't walk on the red ones because they're lava.
Shh, Rusty, please.
Well, after 10 long years, I finally translated the broadcasts. I found something extraordinary. A message from far across time and space addressed to me personally. It has to do with my latest invention, the greatest of my career, or anyone's, which I completed only a week ago.
Turn it up, I smell money.
They warned me that mankind was still too immature to be trusted with it. They told me to dismantle it before it got into the wrong hands.
But they also told me that the fate of the planet hinged upon my machine being activated once. That's why I've scattered the main components in secret locations across the globe. So no one... Someone's coming! They know! False alarm. Okay, get a pen.
Okay.
I'm standing in a bag.
Are you?
This is my old kitchen. I remember this wallpaper. Hey!
Remember.
Remember what? What does this have to do with my super science business? Hello?
Hello, Rusty. You're up bright and early.
I heard noises.
Oh, Daddy had a little sleepover. Say, what you eating there?
Alpha dog! I like Apple Mummy better, though.
Apple Mummy. By the way, the thing is, you've got to get a good breakfast, because breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
King Nutriman's my favorite, but you don't get a prize.
Gah, what are you trying to do to me?
This is the moment your feelings of inadequacy first manifested themselves, that your father turned from role model to tormentor rival. What are you going to do about it?
Tight, Rusty. I'll have you up this in a
jiff. No, do not call out to your father to save you. He is the one who tied you up and buried your dreams in this tomb. He commands these creatures of the dark. Fear, self-loathing, stinking, and dilly-dallying. Free yourself and destroy this temple of failure.
What's all that racket?
The Goliath will not stop crushing your soul until you slay him once and forever. Kill him, take your rightful place on the Venture throne, and become the Golden Boy King Godhead.
Lights out, son. It's time for bed.
Do it! Slay him now and forever be free! The son has become the father, and the floodgates of heaven have opened. Prosperity reigns upon you. But who is this tiny little man? Why is he stealing your birthright?
Nobody move! I'll get it! Gandalf, Fauna's arrived! You read my mind. You need a stiff one in me after that car ride.
Why was I too fast for you, Horace?
Never let a woman drive your Aston, Jonesy. This one handles a stick like it's got hairpiece.
Well, who knows with all the strange garages you park it in. Hello, Dr. Venture.
Miss Quinn.
More like Miss Bollocks, Buster. If she won't take my name, maybe she'll take a smack in her smart mouth.
Try me.
Mom, are you and Horace quarreling again?
No, Tara.
Ah, hello, sunshine. Got your nose.
Hey, now! Take Tara downstairs, would you?
Go with the nice Chinaman, Tara doll.
Ahem. Where do we,
you know.
Pepper!
Oh, you pretty thing.
That's it. Oh, yes, I'm having the time of my life! Show us the way to cleanse ourselves.
You were right to bring him here, Rusty. Now let us see what Father has to say.
Always to wash behind one's ears. Always to wash before bedtime.
Oh, hello, Rusty.
Hello, Father.
Looking well. Enjoying your new life below ground?
Yes, Father.
Ha ha! Good. Because today I'd like to talk to you about personal hygiene.
Yay!
As humanity's last hope, the burden of preserving the American way of life in a post-nuclear world is upon you. Controls flyaways, but it looks and smells great. Two smooth, even strokes each day will mitigate the odors caused by microorganisms which feed upon the sebum from...
You have got to be shitting.
Difficult for me to discuss, but as you get older, you may experience certain urges to miss.
Okay, show's over!
That's right, a veritable subterranean utopia. Why, we even have our own concert hall with a 90-piece classical orchestra. Yes, sir, old Jonas thought of just about everything.
Venture.
Don't worry, I found him. He's right here. And he wants to talk to you, too.
Oh, hello, Rusty.
No, Dr. Venture. It's Mother.
You're looking well. Enjoying your new life below ground?
No, Dr. Venture. We have much to talk about.
Ha ha! Good. Because today I'd like to talk to you about personal hygiene.
Oh, okay.
Behold! If Venture does not surrender to us within the hour, we will feed his boy to my ravenous Peronus.
Fantastic!
Classic! I'll bet I know what Dr. Venture will say when he gets a load of that.
What is that, my uncharacteristically hirsute agent comrade?
Go, Team Venture! Go, Team Venture!
Wait. Oh, come on!
Action! Action!
you doing?
What? I'm winning the day!
I'll take it down a notch. I mean, Ukuk is a mindless savage, and even he knows when to pull his punches. Ook, ook.
My chest hurts. My tongue is too weak for my mouth.
Take five, you mongoloid. You fought bravely.
Oh, it's the best. It's the best.
Somebody ran across the sentence.
What the devil is that?
Italian. It's a self-destruct countdown.
Oh, why do they always get a pull there?
Fan out, Team Venture. We've got to find that bomb. False alarm.
So, you fellas think that champagne's still cold?
Say, Dickie, get a picture of us in our new headquarters, will ya?
You betcha, Doc. Okay, everyone, say go Team Venture.
Go Team Venture!
And that's how Dad captured Spider Skull Island.
What would you say is your greatest adventure? And parenthetically, what is your greatest invention?
Well, Dick, those are both excellent questions, but I'm afraid I only have one answer. My son.
Oh, that's so sweet.
So I don't know. Sometimes I wish I could just be a normal kid and go out and play with kids my own age and stuff. The only people I get to hang out with are grown-ups. The only time I get to leave the compound is to go someplace creepy like the Bermuda Triangle. And then I get kidnapped by grown-ups. And I'm not even sure I want to be a super scientist when I grow up anyway. But I feel all this pressure because of my It feels weird telling you all this stuff.
Remember, Rusty, in here I'm your doctor, not your father. Now, let's get back to it, shall we? You were telling me how you're ungrateful for all the opportunities your father's given you, and you blame me for all your problems.
So you can see why I've been reluctant to go back into therapy.
A cat has over 100 vocal cords, while the giraffe has none.
Astronomy. The temperature of the sun can reach 15 million degrees Fahrenheit. Anatomy.
There are 9,000 taste buds on your tongue.
And the answer to today's trigonometry problem is...
Well, would you look at that? It would appear that's all the time we have.
Hank and Dean.
Today marks the completion of our progressive electronic cross-disciplinary educational journey together. You're now fully prepared to embark on your first solo adventure. To college. And the fulfilling life of super science that awaits beyond. So, I suppose the only thing I have left to say is...
Congratulations!
Hank and Dean.
Fascinating. You're right, Rodney. The wreck of that old trireme is full of ancient drachmas.
Heck, that's great news, Doc. We've got a wedding to get to.
Jackie, oh, I'd almost forgotten. Helper! Stow those for me, would you?
Yeah! I slay the Minotaur!
Slew. You slew the Minotaur, Rusty. And I brought you along to Greece to expose you to the classics, not to play Mad Monsters Party.
Ahoy! Last party boat to Scorpios! Action!
No, don't wait up, Rust. Daddy won't be back till late. Famous public, book one, and then straight...
I bested you, Venture. Do you yield?
Go to hell, Ron. Elrond.
Jonas, help!
Action! Engrams! Get out of my head!
Don't you know a faint when you see one? Kidnapping the former First Lady was all but a distraction for my real target.
Apollo? The Apollo 7, scheduled to splash down today!
Wally's on that mission!
You see, Dr. Venture, it's all a big misunderstanding. Here, take some olive oil for your trouble.
Well, like I always say, oil's well that ends well.
Kano, take Rusty outside, would you? I'd like to compensate these fine gentlemen for their time.
Bye-bye, George Jones.
Bye-bye, Rusty.
Horace, lock the door.
Oh, no. Hey. No.
You'll never get away with this, Scaramantula!
Ah, but I already have, Dr. Venturi. And before I finished this precocious 47 Monfortino, my mecha tarantula, he will finish you!
Italian spiderbot. If it's engineered anything like your Fiat, we've not to worry about.
Because... If it isn't the blue Morpho. If you think you can just waltz in here and muscle in on my racket, you've got another thing coming to the...
It's another think coming. God! No need to be alarmed, Dr. Venture. I'll have you free in a jiff. You're in the hands of the blue...
Blue Morpho. Yes, I've heard of you. Nothing good, I'm afraid.
Ow! Wait a minute! I'm not... Ow!
But after that, they become like friends and stuff. He shows up again in issue 36 when they team up to fight L. Ron Hubbard.
Yeah, super.
Can't seem to get that darn song out of my head.
Street life. I, the Crusader.
I know. It's the last thing I remember before the darkness. I've no idea how long I was out. But one fateful day, I awoke. I was unable to move or speak. But I could see and hear.
It's on! It's off! It's on! It's off! It's on! It's off! It's on! Off! It's
I tried to communicate with them, but they mustn't teach the cadets Morse code anymore. Soon, the blackness came for me again. But I knew I was on Gargantua 1. I built her! I could communicate with her! We had a miscommunication. I was alone, disconnected. Forced to forage for protein as my backup battery slowly died. Until a savior brought me here. I call him Venturian.
I call him an abomination. You've gone too far this time, Jonas.
I thought you'd all be pleased. I saved our friend's life.
Yeah, but what kind of life is this? Ah, this is just wrong.
He's frozen solid! Lost him, Rodney.
Don't you see that? We just need to get him into the program. Oh, and I kicked Jonas Venture's ass, too.